Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to do another design tutorial. So recently I made this post on the YouTube community page and I asked you which one of these four from Creative Fabrica should I use, and it was a close race, but the most votes were to C. So I'm going to take this one from Creative Fabrica C and create a design for it, so show you how I would do it in Canva. So a couple of you asked to do it in Canva. I usually do it in Affinity Designer because I have more control, but let's see how it goes in Canva using this design from Creative Fabrica. All right, so here I am in Creative Fabrica. Let's go find that one. It's on the home page, I know. There it is. So this one. I'm in Creative Fabrica, so I can download this already. I've paid, I have a subscription there. If you don't have one, I'll put a link in the description to Creative Fabrica, but like, I think now's like one of the best times to do it. $3.99 a month, that's crazy. So you can just hit download here. I've already done that. And then it's gonna save it as a file, a folder file, zip file. Double click on the zip file and you'll see it. I'll pull it up here. So here's the zip file that it came in. I double clicked on it and then I got this PNG right there. So I'm gonna use that PNG. It's a transparent PNG. And so most people would just use it as is, but I'm not gonna use it as is because everybody can do that and I wanna stand out from the crowd. Another way I'm gonna stand out from the crowd is make it on a black t-shirt instead of a white. You see all the examples here on white, and of course, because the text is black, they put it on a white t-shirt. I'm gonna do the opposite to stand out. So I'm gonna try and put it on a black t-shirt, change the words. I'm gonna keep the graphics, but let's change the words and change it up a little bit just so that it's different. All right, so here I am on Canva. The first thing I would do is I would go to create and I would do custom size 4500 by 5400. If you don't have this preset or recent, you can type it in 4500, 5400 pixels and go, and it will make an artboard here. So next step I would do is grab that PNG and drag it in. I'll just drag it in here. Boom, perfect. The nice thing about this is it is a PNG, and Canva recently in the last year or two made it so that you can edit PNGs or erase PNGs or, you know, remove the background. We don't need to remove the background on here, but we definitely, I'm definitely gonna remove some of these things. So I'm gonna use the magic eraser right here and I can just like come over this. I'm not gonna do the text, this text right here, nor this one. This one, I might keep some of the stars, but they're not gonna show up on black. So maybe not. I'll get rid of those stars too, just the black ones. Whoops, I think I went too close to that. Is there a command Z? There's not, so I'm gonna trash this and do it all over. Just be careful, I think I went too close to that. Yeah, I went too close, so I'm gonna hit command Z there. You can hit command Z after. So maybe get the close ones first, just so, yeah, there we go. You can also size down this brush. So if you need to get just that little dot here and these stars, don't wanna get these black ones. Yeah, and that. And I'm actually in the way, so I'm gonna move myself here. All right, and then I can make the brush bigger once I like don't need to get so close. This is gonna take a little while, so I'm gonna speed through this one in the video so you don't have to watch me do the whole thing. All right, so I got to a point where I covered all of them. You can see the only thing I'm really keeping are the two cups and a couple of stars or three stars here that are not, I should have kept that one, but it's kind of far out there. So what I need to do is just hit erase, and what I'm gonna be left with are the things that I didn't erase, the cups here. Oh, I missed this little and this little spot. So I can go back and erase again. Let's see, that right there, this little spot, and that little spot there. Did we get everything else? I think so. Let's do this erase again. Sometimes you miss something, and there is a lot to take away. So there we go, pretty cool. And then I'm just gonna go back. Boom, so that's all I'm left with. Nice, so I can put it on a black t-shirt now without any problem. Check that out. I think that works a lot better. I'm gonna move myself back here. Okay, so next thing we're gonna do is I wanna find like something I can put here. Maybe some pre-made text or something about coffee. I'll do coffee. Boom. I'm sure there's some coffee saying somewhere in here. Coffee shop, that would be cool. Bold coffee, maybe Halloween since this is ghost coffee. We'll find something. Whoops, I gotta spell it right. Some ghost coffee. I love these ghost coffee ones. I would use more of those, and these wildflower ones, really cool. So let me try something. Sometimes you can click on this. I'm not gonna use this, but there's magic recommendations. And there's a trick or treat there, trick or treat there. No. Let me try another one. I'll go back. And this guy, magic recommendations. Booyah, happy spooky season. That kind of cool. Booyah. Let's try. Of course, we'd have to make that white. That could kind of work. Let's see what else we got. Trick or treat, happy spooky season, eat, drink. Oh, this trick or treat's kind of cool. So I'm gonna do another duplicate page, take out booyah, and this is just me brainstorming, right? Like I can, like this is kind of cool. What if we put this in the back? There, sent it back, boom. We could also remove like some things in this one too. Like maybe I don't want this and this because it's in the way. You know what? I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna hit. Oh, this isn't. This is a. Never mind. This is not a PNG. So I'm gonna just place it over like that. I think that would be cool. Booyah kind of is neat if I can put this in the front. Layer line, bring to front. Boom. That's not bad either. Okay, let's see what else we got. Maybe coffee sayings. I'm gonna go coffee saying. So you see what I'm doing is I'm taking the graphic, but then changing it and using Canva to do another, like come up with something else. So I could do, let's see, is there a fun one here? Yeah, so there's a bunch of coffee ones here that I could use. Let's just click on this one and then see what else they got. I'm looking for one that's more, not as tall, because we already got the height of the mugs there, right? Or the coffee. More coffee, please, start with coffee. Coffee power, we could do that. Coffee lover, that's a cool one. All you need is coffee. So you can see there's a whole bunch of stuff that I could use. Let's see. Yeah, something like, see this? It's not as tall, and I can still use the cups here. Boom, see how that looks? That works perfect. Life is a journey. And then we can put something funny underneath that kind of ties it all together. So life is a journey, spooky and you need coffee or something, right? So let's do like that. This one is already coffee break. I just noticed that. This one says coffee break. I'm gonna do white here so we can see. So it's just something like that. And then I'm gonna do the effects in the other way. Look at that. Our totally original design now. Oh, I gotta spell coffee right. E. Right? Life's a journey. And then you got the coffee cups. It's spooky and you need coffee. Or something like that, right? Like, that's really cool. Trick or treat. I could come in here and change this to the color that's already there to kind of match it together. I think the other one said cream and sugar or something like that. So I'll do that too. Cream and sugar, right? And make sure that this is white. Oh, all of it is white. Come on, dude. Well, I'm not spelling good today. Sugar. And I think we can use another, that vintage font too. That would be cool. Let's see. We got Canva Sans, Jeepers. Ooh, Jeepers. Ooh, that's kind of cool. I'll stop picking that. And we could do with. Right, something like that. Booyah. And then we could do something like, I don't know. Just brainstorming here. You could use ChatGPT to brainstorm different things too. I'm scary before coffee. Right? Something like that. There you go. I think these would be good. I want to move, like, let's do the same effect on this one. Just go the other way, because there we go. All right, so which one do you think does better? Life's a journey, it's spooky and you need coffee. Trick or treat, like we made three of them with this, and it wasn't too bad in Canva, on like them all. Let me show you what you do after you're done. Let's say we did this one. If you're lucky enough to have Canva Pro, I think you need Canva Pro for some of the things that I did here. You would just hit download, PNG, make sure you like transparent background. That's the big benefit of Canva Pro. The other benefit is that you got all the apps and all the graphics and everything, so why not do Canva Pro? I'm just gonna do all three pages and I'm gonna hit download, boom. And these will be all ready to go for your print on demand. I'll show you right here where it comes out, but I think it's still downloading. Yeah, there we go. Downloading right there. And then now it's different, right? It's on a black t-shirt, not on a white t-shirt. It's totally different phrase and everything. So people may see like the same graphic that other people are using, but it's gonna be something that stands out, right? Especially, I like picking the graphics. Canva has a lot of text graphics that look really good, like their art. Like if you just put text on there, it's not as, doesn't give it that much of an oomph, but like finding these, like that really makes it stand out with the graphic and like a graphical text, right? So look for those, as well as like, I think this font's really good for Halloween too. So let me show you what it comes up with. There, it puts it in a zip file here. And in a folder, and now I have all three. I have this PNG, transparent background, ready to go, right size, 5400 by 4500 by 5400, and look great on a t-shirt, on a black one for sure, and then different colors too. So yeah, we can see what this would look like just by changing the colors. Let's say it was gonna be on like a dark red t-shirt. Let's see, did we not? There, like that, that still would work on that, all of these colors here. So this could work on a like a darker color like that too. Like it still would work on some dark colors. So ooh, dark gray would look really cool, right? So have fun with that. There you go. Let me know what other ones you want me to do. I think this is fun. We can do this once a week or something. So there you go. That's how I would use letter C in Canva. I think that's nice that we picked C and we used Canva. Next time we'll pick A and use Affinity Designer or something like that. I don't know what I could use for B though. But anyway, hopefully this was really helpful. Let me know in the comments if you want to see more like this. And make sure to watch other design videos that I have. I'll put the latest one here that I did in Canva as well. Thanks again for watching. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.